Good morning everyone. Again welcome to our chemistry session. I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to discuss the concept of the atom and the molecule. All of you take out your book. Those who don't have the book, please stay on video. In 1803, Dalton gave the concept of the atom. The smallest part an element is made up of is an atom. The smallest part of an element that is made of a smallest particle that is called an atom. All atoms of an element are alike. But the atoms of different elements are different. All atoms of an element are alike, and each and every element made up of a smallest particle that is called an atom. In 1803, Dalton gave this concept. An atom may combine with other atom of the same element to form a molecule of the element. An atom may combine with other atoms of the same element to form a molecule. Means an atom joins and forms a molecule. A molecule can exist independently, but an atom generally does not. A molecule can exist independently, but an atom cannot. That is why an atom of hydrogen combines with another of the same element to form a molecule of hydrogen. Similarly, two atoms of oxygen combines together to form a molecule of oxygen. So generally we can conclude that to form a molecule, two atoms or should be joined in case of oxygen. When atoms of different elements combine together, what is formed is a molecule of a compound. For example, an atom of oxygen combines with two of hydrogen to form a molecule of the compound water. And one atom of carbon combines with two oxygen to form a molecule of a compound carbon dioxide. It's called a CO2. The chemical formula of water, that is called H2O. Okay, you can see how atoms are joined in a molecule in figure 1.3. Here you see hydrogen, oxygen and water. Hydrogen H2. Oxygen O2, water H2O. Okay, two atoms of hydrogen, two atoms of oxygen forms oxygen, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combines and forms water. The atomic theory gave a great boost to the development of not only chemistry but all branches of science. The atomic theory. The starting of atomic theory boosts the development of the science. Now we are going to discuss some founding fathers of modern chemistry. First of all, we are going to discuss about a famous scientist, Robert Boyle. Robert William Boyle was born to a noble family on 25 January 1776. 1627 in Ireland. At the age of 8, he was sent to Eton College, where he studied for 6 years. When he was 14, he set out on a long journey with a tutor. After spending about 4 years touring and studying in different parts of Europe, he returned to England. Thereafter, he devoted his life to scientific research. He soon became an important member of the Invisible College. In fact, this was not a college, but a society of those who possessed the new philosophy of science. It was the Invisible College which was made the Royal Society by the King in 1663. Boyle was made a fellow of this society. He was in Oxford for a few years doing research, but when his health started failing, he came to London and lived with his elder sister. He refrained from public engagements and spent his time doing research. Boyle carried out his research in various subjects: physics, chemistry, oceanography, gemology, blood science, and so on. He was the first scientist to have prepared a substance simpler than water. Which was later established to be hydrogen. He rejected Aristotle's theory that water is an element. Thus, modern chemistry can be said to have begun with him. He studied the behavior of gases. He discovered that at a fixed temperature, the volume of gas decreases with increasing temperature and increasing with the decreasing temperature. This is Boyle's law. Once again, please underline, Boyle's law is decreases with increasing pressure, increases with the decreasing pressure. This is called a Boyle's law. He authored more than 20 books on different aspects of science, including one titled The Skeptical Chemist, meaning the Doubtful Chemist. Robert Boyle died on 31 December 1691. Okay, tomorrow we'll discuss about Antony Lavoisier, another famous scientist. Till then, wait for the section and goodbye.